Hey, hello. So I did one Honeybee tutorial where we reversed engineered as an existing script a annual daylight study of a simple room with a window and louvers, and we tested or we calculated the annual daylight for the room with and without with open and closed louvers. But I thought it would be good to roll back a bit because I think it's important to understand Honeybee from ground up. So in this video, we're gonna start to look more closer, more deeper into the core, the Honeybee core tools, and then the energy modeling. So what we did last time was Honeybee radiance. It's all about light. It's about sunlight, daylight studies, and then there's energy modeling where you basically try to estimate heating, cooling, electricity, and so on for a building or for a room. And we will build a very simple script, but focusing more on the core elements at first. And then as a result have one a very simple script which gives you the very rough estimate of the annual load of a room or a building. For that reason, I looked into the original energy modeling tutorials from Chris Mackey, one of the founders of the Ladybug tools, and he did his tutorials with the legacy tools, and I try to translate that into the new Ladybug tools. Having said that, the difference is that I'm a designer, and that's why it's important to mention that I would not recommend to use the data and use it directly on a project. I would always go to an engineer or somebody who knows the thing inside out and verifies my findings, because the topic is so vast and there's so many things to consider that I can really just show some of the basics. I'm very good with putting things together, but I'm not the engineer who can verify or tell you what is good or what is bad. I can only make assumptions. So please keep that in mind. So if you are a designer and you're just playing around, don't use the data or whatever comes out of this on a project. It can become really bad for you. So I would always go to the engineer, to a consultant, to verify or even maybe they do the study themselves, and then you can compare with what you came up. So in that way you can learn. And you can go in a discussion with a consultant much more informed. So I think that's the reason why I want to understand these tools. Yeah, another thing before we start, the first tutorial I did with the Ladybug tools 1.2, that worked fine with the radiance and with the daylight study. However, for this tutorial, I had to go back to 1.1 because there is a bug. Obviously, where the energy plus component is not is found, but it tells me I have the wrong version installed, as in fact I have the right version installed. So I had to go back to the Ladybug 1.1, and now it works fine. So the Ladybug 1.1 is slightly different to the Ladybug 1.2, but it's not as it's. But I think if you understand the Ladybug tools 1.1, then you won't have any issue to understand the 1.2. So in a way it doesn't matter. And yeah, and first we will go through the installation because I think it's important. So I will show you how I installed it and then how you verify your installation. So you can verify it within Grasshopper. You can see where are the different components installed and which versions are installed. So we do that first and then we start to build the script. Let's start in Food for Rhino, foodforrhino.com. You need to have an account. This is for free. Just create an account. And then you go to Ladybug Tools, Tools, and then yeah, you find Ladybug tools, and then you will see download, and that leads you to the download portion of the page. And what I used is Ladybug tools 1.1.0, And I have actually downloaded both, so if I want to change quickly, I can do that. You can of course try the 1.2, and if it works for you, then it's perfect. For the energy modeling in Honeybee, for me, it only works at the moment with the 1.10. So you go to download. I will not click that here, but just download. And then when you download it, you should have the Ladybug tools here as a zip file. You unzip it, then you have you get this. That's what's inside, and then you have the installer. And just here are the installer instructions. A full list of installation instructions for Windows and Mac can be found at GitHub Ladybug Tools, Ladybug Tools Grasshopper Wiki. That's I very much want to recommend to go there. It's important. But yeah, I will also tell you how it works. So you can either go here or you can go to GitHub. And I will also go to GitHub now, so you will see it. So I will copy this here in my. I just copy the link. And yes, so if you go on GitHub, you need to find this page here, the Windows installation steps. Download the latest version. Okay, for me it's 1.10. And then we open Rhino. I open it as a administrator. And then in Grasshopper, we launch Grasshopper either by the symbol or by typing Grasshopper. And then we open the installer, open document, that case I'm already here, installer open, and it will also tell you exactly what to do. Be careful, because it doesn't tell you everything, as I realize. So we just click here on the false, on the toggle, and in that case it tells me it's already installed. It should install it under your username, on the C drive users, and then your name or the admin, if you're the admin, and then Ladybug Tools. And then it tells you what to do next. Run the installer component below, and then you click here and it installs everything. And then you need to go into your user admin Ladybug Tools folder. I'll do that quickly just to show you. Admin and then Ladybug Tools. And then you need to run this set Python path. Double click and then press continue, and then it's done. And then optional installation steps include install OpenStudio, install Radiance. And here a lot of people make the mistake that they just open, including me, that they just go for the website, OpenStudio and Radiance, and just install whatever is there. Hold on, stop, go to this page, back to this page, and read. So optional steps, install Radiance. Actually, here is also misleading, a bit misleading, because Radiance, so it says here install OpenStudio and install Radiance. Radiance is actually part of the OpenStudio installation. So in theory, you don't need to install Radiance. You only need to install OpenStudio, and then you have everything you need. So you can go here, this link, which is also here, is the Compatibility Matrix. And that's important because that tells you exactly which Radiance version works with which which Ladybug tools work with which version of Python, Radiance, and OpenStudio. And you actually, in that case, I have the 1.10. I only need to download this one, the 3.01. So that's what you download. You go here. And by the way, yeah, you can try the other versions, of course, but this is what I had to do. And then I just need to install it. So if I go here, I'll download it, of course, a lot of times. And then I just double click, and then it asks me where. I would just use the folder which is recommended, and that's it. Okay, I will not install it now. So just go for the installation. It will tell you when it's finished. So that's pretty much done. Now, how to verify what you installed? That's a good thing. So I will just close this. No, don't need that. So I'm here. And what you can do now in order to verify or check what you installed, you can go here into, no, it's just Honeybee Config. Yes, that's the one. This is the one, and then there's another one. There's another check versions. Yes, that's the one. So these are very useful if you want to confirm what you have. You just open a panel and then you just plug this in here. Let's make a few of these. It tells you, so Python is the version 3.71, which is 3.71, yeah. 9, sorry. And then it tells you where it is. It tells you where the Python installation is. And then we can do the same with Radiance. Radiance is the 5.49. And it's, because I installed it twice, I installed it separately and then with OpenStudio, so I have the newest version of Radiance, which is fine. It seems it works, so I don't need to change it. And again, I can check where is the installation. By the way, you can also check where the Python library is, and you can check Radiance. And then we have OpenStudio, so we have Python, Radiance, OpenStudio, 3.01, and Energy Plus. And that gives me the 930. Let's check that. It's not written here, but that's fine. I know it works. The latest one is 9.5, I think. Yeah, you can check just where it's installed. See, Radiance installed here, OpenStudio is installed here. And if I want to know where the Energy Plus is, then you can check it out here. So that's, and then you have some other stuff, standards. That's how you're able, if you have to check if you installed everything correctly.